I've always looked back on these verses in Proverbs, chapter 3, verses 5 through 6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways submit to him, and he will make your path straight.
Margo, you look stunning. I didn't have to write that. That was just there.
Did you write that already?
Wanted to remind myself.
No matter what has been thrown at us in our lives, even when we couldn't comprehend why, we still had faith that God had a plan for us and we would get through whatever circumstance we were facing.
Your physical beauty, however, pales in comparison to the beautiful heart and soul that you possess. That is the beauty that I truly fell in love with.
God knew every single situation we would have to go through, the doubt, confusion, hurt, and pain, to lead us, prepare us, and strengthen us for the day we were to meet each other.
Your greatest gift is your Christ-loving heart that I am truly blessed to say I stole.
I heard this phrase, if God is making you wait, then be prepared to receive more than you asked for. And I definitely got more than I asked for. And it's not about what I wanted or prayed for throughout the years. It's about what God knew I needed in a relationship and in a marriage. He couldn't have chosen anyone better to complement my life in all aspects. It's like you've always been a part of my life.
From our first date, where I had you at Prosciutto, and for my non-Italians out there, that is Prosciutto, the Italian ham. From that moment, I had no doubt that you were the one I wanted to spend the rest of my life with.
And I know my family would say the same. The numerous times we're all sitting around the table and just uncontrollably laughing and in hysterics, it's priceless. We have all become one family, and God knew I needed a man who would fit right in with mine and mine with his.
As our relationship and love grew, I knew that you were also the one that I wanted to tackle life with. Everyone here knew there was going to be a football reference at some point, so we got it in.
Not only do we laugh and have fun together, but one of the many characteristics that attracted me to you is your drive in life and perseverance through tough times. We've always committed to being a team in our relationship and to get through the trials and challenges together because we know it will not always be easy. To do this successfully, we put a high value on what marriage truly means, our communication with each other, and the role the Lord needs to play in our relationship.
As I peeled away the layers of who you are and who we are as a unit, I realized that I have the partner who I can and will accomplish anything with. You motivate, inspire, and drive me to be a better man, husband, and someday father, more than I could ever be on my own.
Respect, love, and appreciation are just a few of the things and the main actions in a marriage that we discussed when we initially met and what we currently live out in our relationship.
When we have tough days and hard times, I want you to always lean on me for the support you need. But most importantly, I want us to always remember that Jesus Christ is the bedrock of our marriage. With him on our sideline, more football analogies. With him on our sideline, we'll always be okay.
There must be a God. I believe it's true. My promise to you is to continue respecting you as the man and leader in our home. To continue loving you by my words and most like, and more importantly, by my actions. To continue appreciating the big and the little things that you do for me every single day and to verbalize my appreciation to you. My promise is to make you feel how you make me feel every day. There are a few things I did leave out but haven't forgotten. You include me in all your passions and life. And I will be by your side through all Dolphins wins and losses and every WWE match imaginable.
Finally, I'd like to speak to love. Probably not as well as David just did, but I'm going to try it anyways. One of the most powerful and meaningful scriptures regarding love being 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 4 to 8. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and most importantly, always perseveres.
You see these hands you have. I love you so much.
I knew I should have went first.
Just ain't strong enough. And what tomorrow brings, only time will tell. But I will stand by you in sickness and in health, 'cause I have never been so sure of anything before, like I am in this moment here with you. And now for better or for worse, so much more than only words. And I pray every day will be the proof that I as the years march on, like a beating heart, I will live these words till death do us part. 'Cause I have never been so sure of anything before, like I am in this moment here.
Oh,